Good evening. This is Between the Lines Live, Decision 2018. It's election day. The primary election's taken place. The polls close in less than a half hour, and we'll bring you all of the results right here, fast, furious, first, at SanduskyRegister.com. Stay tuned all evening. We're also going to be interviewing guests all evening in the political spectrum. We're going to start with Erie County Commissioners Matt Old and Pat Shenigo, but also we're going to have Commissioner, former City Commissioner Julie Farrar on. She's a candidate in the Democratic primary this evening. We're also going to have Tim Reister on later in the program. He's also a candidate in the Democratic race, the primary. Steve Schaffner, a Republican, who if he votes for himself, he will get the Republican nomination. So it's going to be a face-off in November of Steve Schaffner versus Julie Farrar, Brad Hartung, or Tim Reister. That'll be interesting, but we're going to bring you all the results tonight, including the governor's race, the race between Richard Cordray and Dennis Kucinich, and everything else. Fast, furious, first, right here. Get the results. Stay tuned all evening. Come to SanduskyRegister.com for updates and look to Between the Lines. And with that, I'll introduce our first guest, Commissioners Pat Shenigo and Matt Old. Thank you for being on the program.
Thanks for having us.
Well, I guess the first thing I should ask is about this primary tonight. Steve Schaffner is going to be the Republican nominee, and Matt, you're from the Republican Party, and Mr. Shenigo, you're from the Democratic Party. Do either of you have a favorite in the race? Are you supporting the Democrat? Are you supporting the Republican? Is it warfare?
Oh, it's definitely warfare. Wouldn't you?
I would say it's certainly not warfare.
No, I think, the voters get to decide this, not us. And I think I especially have proven that I can work with anybody.
And that, you've had, Commissioner Bill Monahan will be leaving at the end of the year, and you've had a mixed run with Mr. Monahan. I think for the first 5 years it worked well, and then for the last 5 years it hasn't worked well. Does that about sum it up?
It about sums it up.
And so are you looking forward to having some new face on commission?
Well, I think it's been breath of fresh air to have Matt Old join the commission because, we share a lot of the same philosophies on not spending money where it's not needed, and I think we've got along fine, and we don't always agree on everything, but when we don't agree, he's usually right.
And Matt, you were a Berlin Township trustee, mm-hmm. and a Berlin Heights councilman, if I remember correctly.
Correct.
You at different times.
Yep.
And I remember one thing you said about expenditures. Is, I think it was a backhoe for Berlin Township and a backhoe for Berlin Heights. And
yeah.
You couldn't figure out why they couldn't share it.
Exactly.
So how is it going? You're 2 years in as county commissioner?
Year and a half.
Year and a half. And, you're looking at expenditures. Are you seeing the same thing? Are you finding ways to reduce expenses? And
yeah, I think we've looked around and seen a lot of areas where we can reduce expenses. And we have in the short run. But in the long run, looking at just doing things in a different way, I think Commissioner
right.
Shenigo and I agree, we need to take a hard look at things, not have everything farmed out to very expensive engineering firms who over-engineer projects, and they make millions of dollars
right.
when we could spend hundreds of thousands to get the product
right.
we need.
Right.
And we've seen over Erie County's history, I'd love to total it up someday, but it has to be millions of dollars,
millions of dollars.
On projects that we don't even have. And then millions of dollars on projects that we have that we're going to have to go back and fix because they weren't done right.
The water line, the rural water line being one.
Yeah.
Now you did, I think was it earlier this, no, it was last year, where you eliminated the Environmental Services Department, effectively putting Jack Myers out of work.
Well, we didn't eliminate it, we reorganized it. And what we did is in the business that I'm in, a lot of times the guys that are out there doing the work, the superintendents, I say the guys in the work boots, they know, they have a pretty good understanding of what is the best way to do it at the best price. What we did is we looked at, one project comes to mind was a sludge dewatering thing. that I was adamant against for $2 million or whatever they were.
That was spend. More recent.
More recently. And well, it turns out we spent, what, 200 and some thousand
on the engineering.
And the crazy part was, is that we're going to build that same $2.1 million project, same piece of equipment that spins the solids for under $600,000. And same thing. And one engineer designed it.
But it's only taxpayer money. I mean.
Well, no, we don't look at it. We look at it the same as our money. So, but you know, they were going to build a building, and they were a bomb-proof building. And what I think the most people don't understand in the public, at least I didn't understand when I got into this, was, you know, the engineers, architects, any professional services are hired on a who's most qualified. And that's such an arbitrary question. So we scale, you know, if you're the engineering firm and I like you, we can scale that you're most qualified because the questions are, how many projects have they done? How close are they to project? One of the questions I loved is how interested are they in obtaining this work? Well, of course they're interested.
It's millions of dollars.
Yeah. Then Erie County would hire them on a percentage. So the more the project costs, the more they make. So I'm going to design that project with gold-plated pipes because I'm going to make more money. And so I think, you know, we don't do that anymore. It's a fixed
There's a lot cost. You don't do anymore. And, the battles have been fought. The victories have been, added up. Tom Farrell is no longer a commissioner, but he is the common denominator in that expenses that were through the roof, $167 million deficit?
$120,
which is down now to under 100, down now
it's
to...
It's down to about 60-something.
60.
But, you know, understand, a lot of that debt was, you know, $30 million for a landfill. That sold as a bond.
Long term.
And you can't pay it off.
You can't pay it in advance.
What I think the magic that we've been able to do is we just stop spending money.
Right.
You know, we don't build these big, grandiose projects anymore. You know, we have projects in the pipeline that are going to, we do a cost-benefit analysis. We're going to save money by doing these projects.
When you talk about the deficit and you talk about the spending, and you came in as a Democrat and you were anti-expenses, you fought it, you and Mr. Monahan together for a number of years. And then, Matt, you've certainly, that's been your whole political career, is looking for ways to be smarter about spending taxpayer money. But when you think of that money that was spent, you know, $21 million for the landfill,
The water pipes.
The water pipes.
$30 million was the landfill.
So there's $50 million right there. And it was ill-conceived, poorly constructed. In the case of the landfill, overbuilt. You're never going to need that much. And it was running at a loss for years and years and years. But what could you have done with $50 million? That's what areas of quality of life issues, city life issues, what could you have done with all that money?
That's no question.
Well, that's the frustrating part is when you see this and, you know, we get something from the EPA that says you've got to do this. Now we're in a situation where if we didn't have all that debt, that would be something easy to do. The centrifuge is a prime example. You know, we've taken it from $2 million down to $600,000.
The sludge.
In the sludge dewatering. Right. In the old days, they would have taken out $2 million.
It would have gone bigger.
Yeah.
And that's what it did. This started a couple of years ago.
And the engineer would get 200 and some thousand
hours. Right. And 20% basically of the project 15, cost.
Yeah, 15. So. That's the problem in the equation.
So are you here tonight? Now, I wasn't sure about this, but I was pretty sure you were going to announce that you were running for re-election in 2020. Is that right?
That's a long time away. You think we'll be around in 2020?
So that's a yes?
That's a what?
That's not a no. I would note that that's not a no. Would you like to see him run for re-election?
I would. I've told him that.
Well, I'm going to be 60 years old this year.
Wow.
Can you believe that?
I do believe that, actually.
I know.
How are you feeling?
Pretty old.
Well, we certainly appreciate you being on Between the Lines. And starting off our election night coverage, Decision 2018. We're going to have guests all night, and we're going to have results as soon as they come available. First, Fast, Furious, right here at SanduskyRegister.com. Are you polling for anyone tonight? Is there a candidate in any race? Is there a candidate that you want to see win? What about the governor's race?
I really haven't, no. I truly believe that the process will be what it is, and I don't want to taint that by saying, you know, I don't
polls
know who's gonna
win. Are the polls closed? It's 7:30. Is it 7:30 yet?
7:20.
All right, the polls close in 10 minutes. Your impact on the race.
I'm not saying impact the voter.
Oh.
We have to work with whoever wins.
I
Is
see.
That fair to say?
And it's been interesting for me being a former party chairman, and
right.
then you get in this job and you become so...
I remember when you were 21, weren't you?
Yeah, 20. you couldn't, you know, that was my focus then. But now that you're in this job, you're working with Republicans,
right.
you're working with Democrats, and those issues, they don't come up
right.
hardly ever
right.
at the local
right.
level. And when you get up into the state rep, state senate, governor's race, the county is such an arm of the state government.
Right.
Whoever wins, we got to work with.
You got to work with them,
yeah. and we have a great working relationship with our state rep and state senator.
Randy Gardner is the state senator, and Steve Arndt.
We'll be with them tomorrow. At 3:30. We're going down to Columbus to talk about an issue, and you know, he's arranged a meeting for us with, you know, the higher ups with the Mental Health and Services Board.
Well, I'm getting the signal to wind it down. Was there anything else you wanted to share? We have fewer than a million viewers right now. It'll grow as the evening goes on. But
wow,
is there
incredible.
Anything you want to tell? Oh, I know. I did want to talk about the roundabout. The roundabout at Campbell and Bogart. Is that the location? Because there's been a lot of controversy on this. And people have asked us, why are commissioners doing this? And we've said they aren't doing this. That you did not push for this roundabout. Did you? Help us understand how this is coming about.
No, that's an absolutely correct answer.
Yeah.
There are a lot of agencies, all the elected officials in Erie County, their budget flows through the commission. And in most cases, we have discretion on how we divvy up the pie. But with the county engineer, he's a different animal because he's funded primarily 90%+ with your gas tax fees
right.
and your motor vehicle license fees.
Because he's working on roads.
And that money's earmarked. So what we as commissioners could do is say, no, you're not getting any money. And it would sit in a bank and grow forever.
Right.
But we could never go and spend it on anything else. Where if we were to take money away from the sheriff, we could move it to the courts.
Uh-huh.
That's not the case with the county engineer's money. So that money,
because the money is I hate to use this word, funneled.
It's funneled
through the state,
and it's funneled through the commission to the engineer for him to do whatever. We could have no say in what project
right.
he does. He has
so it's
discretion on how to spend.
This is a project by the Erie County Engineer's Office.
And that's
Jack Farshman.
And that's by design. We talked about that earlier this morning. You know, back in the day, the engineer was an engineer and a surveyor. That's the state law. So that precludes most people, most engineers don't have a surveyor license also.
Uh-huh.
But that's a requirement to run for the job. But like Matt was saying, back in the day, the engineer's office is the one that surveyed the road and,
right.
you know, forged the new path. So, you know, that legislatively has never been changed. And, you know, I think Matt and I both have a good working relationship with Jack Farshman, our county engineer. He does a phenomenal job.
He also certainly assisted us when we were searching for county records, and he had
yes.
copies that he had kept going back 20 years.
Jack is a very frugal, he's like me.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, in a lot of sense, he's, you know, he really tries to get the most out of every dollar that the taxpayer you know, gives to him through whatever tax he gets. But I think we are not by design supposed to question if such and such a road gets repaved.
It's not your role.
We don't have expertise.
So the point is it's Jack Farshman's office that's building the roundabout. It's not county commissioners. I just wanted to make that clear because we had a couple calls here at the Register asking us about
that. Well, and I know I had a conversation with somebody today about why didn't Jack Farshman put a stoplight there? And I know his staff has explained this, but it's never, I don't think it's been communicated to the general public. ODOT is the one, they tell me, that controls what's called warrants. How many cars come and go through that
intersection. The count, the traffic count.
If there's not enough count, a car can blow through that red light, and the other car, assuming it's, they don't have to look because they've got a green light, they said it's more hazardous. That's why ODOT is very cautious about where they
put traffic. It's data-driven, too. It's
and they don't have the data.
Yeah.
And they did have a death there, and, you know, whether or not a roundabout is going to be a good idea or a bad idea, I think we're going to find out.
We're going to find out. So. Well, again, thank you so much for being our opening guest on this edition of Decision 2018, the primary race, the May 8th primary. Matt Old, Commissioner Matt Old, and Commissioner Pat Shenigo, thank you for being on our program.
Thank you, sir.
Thank
You're
you.
Welcome. All right,
thank you.
Good to see you.
Appreciate it.
Always good to see you.
Thank you.
We're going to take a break right now, and our next guest is Commission candidate Steve Schaffner. He's a Republican in the Republican primary, and I'm going to ask him, did you vote for yourself? And then we're going to declare the first winner of the race if he says yes. We'll be back in just a few moments with candidate Steve Schaffner.